हाय दोस्तों, मई 2018 सीए फाइनल डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस का एग्जामिनेशन आज कंप्लीट हो गया। कैसे क्वेश्चन आए हुए हैं, क्वेश्चन पेपर हम आप लोगों को दिखाना चाहते हैं। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन जो पूछा गया है वो है, राम रहीम एंड रॉबर्ट्स आर इक्वल पार्टनर्स एसएसएन के इन कंपनी विच वाज फॉर्म्ड विच इफेक्ट फ्रॉम 1/6/2017। द फर्म इज एन ऑथराइज्ड डीलर ऑफ वॉचेज मैन्युफैक्चरर बाय द रिप्यूटेड कंपनी। इट रिपोर्टेड नेट प्रॉफिट एज पर प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट ₹2,50,000 आफ्टर डेबिट क्रेडिट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आइटम्स एंड द आइटम्स हैज गिवन लाइक दिस। फर्स्ट, डेप्रिसिएशन ऑन जनरेटर एंड कंप्यूटर्स ₹1,10,000। वर्किंग पार्टनर सैलरी ₹30,000 पर मंथ फॉर ईच पार्टनर। ऑल द पार्टनर्स आर वर्किंग पार्टनर्स एंड द सैलरी पेड इज ऑथराइज्ड बाय द डीड ऑफ पार्टनरशिप। द क्वेश्चन इज जस्ट 10 marks, वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन द एग्जामिनेशन दिस टाइम्स आस्क। एंड दिस इज द एडिशन एट द पॉइंट लाइक एज डेप्रिसिएशन, लाइक एज द वर्किंग पार्टनर सैलरी कंप्यूटेशन द वेरी सेक्शन 40B। एंड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट हैज गिवन इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल टू द पार्टनर एट द रेट 18%। द टोटल interest on capital of the firm debited to the profit and loss account being 3,60,000. This is the normal provision that you know that the 12% of the interest capital allowed to the partners, there is the given the 18%. Now you can simple calculation, 3,60,000 multiply by 6% divided by 18%, and now the figure comes to out, and this amount to the add because 12% is the allowed as deductions. Donation to the recognized political party 80,000 by cash and 70,000 by the electoral purse. As you know that this is the all donations is disallowed, and add back to the in the case of the computations, even the cash and even the electronic purse transfers. But the this is the deduction and disallowed that additionally in the gross total income. And as monthly rent paid to the partner Ram use his premises at the go down ₹30,000 and it is occupied by 1/10/2017. The market rent of the premises is asset at ₹15,000 per month. No tax was deducted at sources on the rent paid. First, this point is belongs to the section 40A subsection 2A. This is the like the fair market value and payment to the related persons. And the balance part 15,000 per month will be as a deduction allowed. But in this case, there are the another point also missed, that no TDS has been deducted. But that means the 30% of the amount of the total for the 6 months will be disallowed, and 70% will be allowed. Sponsorship fees for the local cricket tournament. This is the next point, is that the firm incurred 5 lakhs by way of expenditure towards the cost of the gold coins awarded to the customers on the first day of the year showroom inaugurations. The cost of the each sold gold coins was less than 10,000, and 1 coin was given for each of buyers on that day selected through lucky dip. No tax was deducted at source on such gold coins given to the customers. Additional information has given the 3 additional informations. 1, depreciation on the tangible assets allowable under section 32 to 37 500. As you know that this is the minus less, not added, this will less. And second point, unrecognized trademark was acquired on 10/7/2017 for ₹3 lakhs. The firm used the trademark on which effect from 1/12/2017, since there was some dispute in the title of the previous owners and was cleared through court decree only in November 2017. And third point is asked, the total turnover of the firm for the year is 31st March 2013 was ₹80 lakhs. Amount realized by cash is 20 lakhs, and the balances of the sale proceed were received through the credit cards RTGS, NEFT before 31st March 2003. That you may, this is point related to the section 44 AD, and if turnover is not up to the 2 crore rupees, and this will be exempted at the rate, taxable value at the rate of 8%, not at the rate of 6%, because the 20 lakhs rupees made in the cash, if 100% in the turnover received in the electronic transfers or checks or etc., then 6% will be taxable income. But in this case, there is the some cash, and so 8% will be presumptive income at the rate of 8%. You are required to compute the total income of the firm applying regular provisions and presumptive provision contained in the section 44 AD of the Income Tax Act 1961 Act to advise the procedural requirement on the opting any of the provision for the purpose of the act. This is a very good question asked, 10 marks, and 1B asked 10 marks also, do part 20 marks questions. First questions, Arnold Limited incorporated in UK has a branch office PE in India. The net profit of the branch as per the statement of the profit and loss account, the year ended 31st March 2018 was rupees 83 lakhs. It includes the following: dividend from the Indian company listed 8 lakhs rupees, dividend from Indian company unlisted 4 lakh rupees, interest received from MMNS Limited at of Mumbai 7 lakhs. The amount was received by the Indian company MMNS Limited in the foreign currency as per the loan agreement dated 1st April 2014, section 194 LC applicable. And fourth point is fee for the technical services received from Barun Company Limited, Kolkata, 25 lakhs. The agreement was made on 10-8-2007 and was approved by the central government. Expenditure incurred for providing technical services, rupees 6 lakhs. And the question also additional information, the total income chargeable to tax as per the provision of the Act, Income Tax Act, rupees 20 lakhs without considering the item 1 to 7, 5 to 4 above. You are required to compute the book profit under section 115JB of the Act of the Assessment Year 2018-19 and also the total income tax liability and the SSC of the SSC. Your working should be should be supported by notes. That means second part 1B has question 115JB and minimum alternative tax. Second question is, BG Private Limited engaged in multiple business. The net profit as per statement of profit and loss account, profit and loss was rupees 52 lakhs for the year ended 31st March 2018. A scrutiny of the statement of profit and loss account revealed the following items, which were the debited credited, wherein 16 marks question asked kiya gaya hai. First, share income at the rate of 25% from the partnership from ABC and Company, Pune, 9,50,000. The company paid. Second point, the company paid rupees 1 lakhs as a service charges to a call center for attending the calls of customers and suppliers. The tax deducted as source on such payment at the rate of 2%. Third point, question number 2, the third point. Expenditure incurred rupees 8 lakhs for digging of wells near the factory for use by public under corporate social responsibility scheme as per the Companies Act 2013. As you know, there is a corporate liability, this will be add back. This is not allowed as expenditure. Grant received from government acquisition of the generators rupees 10 lakhs. The generator was acquired on 1st August 2017. For rupees 35 lakhs, a sum of rupees 5 lakhs was paid as advance by cash to the supplier of generators. The grant amount received is credited to the statement of profit and loss. Depreciation at the rate of 35 lakhs at the rate of rupees at the rate 15%. This point is asked about that. Now, depreciation notional depreciation will be disallowed on which the capital expenditure paid in cash on which depreciation is allowed. Earlier, the revenue expenditure which paid in cash rupees 10,000 rupees was the disallowed. Now, by the amendment 2017, also rupees 10 paid more than rupees 10,000 rupees in cash, the capital expenditure is also disallowed. And this point, fourth point, has been given like this: depreciation part of the notional depreciation will be disallowed in these cases. That will be 5 lakhs. You will deduct the 5 lakhs. The amount is 30 lakhs. Also, one part has been also given, the subsidy 10 lakh rupees from the government will be also reduced from the plant and machinery, and it is already added to the statement profit and loss account, so this will be deducted. And also has given the notes: assume the company is not liable for the additional depreciations. During the year, the company bought textile goods from local supplies. Cash payment was made exceeding rupees 10,000 but below 20,000 rupees in a day to the 15 suppliers, aggregate rupees 2 lakhs. As you know that this is now 10 lakh rupees paid in cash will be disallowed. Then 2 lakh rupees will be added in the profit. Depreciation debited to the profit and loss account rupees 10 lakhs. It includes the 8 lakh rupees being the depreciation on the assets revalued. And now this will be the added, including the revalued item. Provisions for the deferred tax is statement profit and loss account. This also will be add back. Trade creditors 5 lakhs was outstanding for more than 5 years and there is no business relationship with them. The amount was unilaterally transferred to the credit of the statement or profit and loss account. Royalty income in respect of the patents chargeable under section 115 BBF rupees 12 lakhs and royalty incomes depreciation eligible under section 32. Before the considering the adjustment of any of the item described above, 12,25,000, this amount will be deducted. And some three additional point has also given additional information. The SSC executed only the one civil construction contract of the value of rupees 15 lakhs. The contract withhold 20% of the contract amount, which would be released. It will be released only after 2 years. The amount withhold has not been credited to the statement of the profit and loss account. The point number A says that if any retention money was not treated as the turnover, but now after the amendment 2017, now any retention money will be treated as a income. So the 20% 15 lakhs, 3 lakhs amount will be add to the profit. And part B, during the 1 lakh, during the year 1 lakh equity share of rupee 10 which were the issued for rupee 25 per share, the fair market value of the shares as per the rule 111 UA of the Income Tax Act 1960 was the determined at the rate of 70 rupees per UA share. 5.C, during the year the company advanced rupees 5,50,000 to one of the directors having 22% equity shares or equivalent voting rights in the company to meet his personal expenses. The company has accumulated profit of 25 lakhs as on 31st March 2017. Point number C belongs to section 2, section 22, section E, deemed dividend. You are required to compute the total income for the assessment year 2018-2019, stating clearly the reason for the treatment for each of the item given above. And next question number 3, for part A, 4 marks. Mr. A is taxable in case of certain incomes as per the Income Tax Act 1961. The DTAA, which is applicable to him, excludes the income earned by him from the purview of tax. Is Mr. A eligible to pay tax on the income earned by him under Income Tax Act 1961? And question number 3, point B has given the three parts. and each part has the two equal marks. First part is the company X and company Y who have entered into the advance pricing agreement APA and eligible for the rollback provisions merged to from company XY. Is the company XY eligible for the rollback provisions as it was the formed on merger of company X and company Y? And question number 3, part B, part 2, proceedings before TPO were stayed by court order and it was the subsequently lifted. The time limit for the completion of the assessment after excluding the period of stay due to the court order is only 30 days. Within how many more days the TPO has to pass this order? And question number 3, B, part 3, 2 marks. The gross total income of Sachin Company Pune was Rs. 70 lakhs, which is wholly attributable to a unit located to SEZ since April 2011. Adjustment to the total income made by the assessing officer by applying the transfer pricing provisions enhanced the total income by Rs. 50 lakhs. What is the total income of the SSC chargeable to tax and explain why? And 3C, also question 6 marks. BNG Limited, a domestic company, has deducted TDS at the of ₹28,451 during the quarter 1 of financial year 2017-18. They had filed the TDS return for quarter 1 on 15-9-2017, the Income Tax Department has sent a notice of demand to the company wherein a fee was levied under Section 234E of the Income Tax Act 1961 for ₹8,800. The company paid the demand raised by the department and also claimed such business expenditure during the assessment year 2018-2019. Discuss whether the demand raised by the department is correct as per the provision of the Act. Also explain whether fee paid under Section 234E can claimed as a deduction while computing the income under the head profit and gains of business or profession. That means Section 234 is like as a fine and penalty and it's related to the income tax. It is not a normal business expenditure, so this is will be the disallowed. This is not the allowable expenditures. Question number 4. Answer any 4 out of the following 5 cases. Your answer will be cover issue involved, provisions, applicable analysis and the conclusion. As you know that question number 4 also divided into 4 part. And first question, Bose and Company is a partnership firm consisting of the 4 partners with equal shares. The partnership firm is engaged in the acquisition of the civil construction contract with the state government authority. The partnership have firm deposited 50 lakhs in the State Bank of India for the purpose of obtaining guarantee as and when the tenders were applied by the firms. It also kept rupees 10 lakhs in a fixed deposit with the Canara Bank being the surplus funds of the firm. The firms created interest on bank deposit of 4 lakh rupees from the SBI and 30 rupees from the Canara Bank in the profit and loss account and computed the working capital, working partner salary based on the firm recruited bank salary based on the resultant book profit. The assessing officer wants to the tax interest income as the income under the other sources and accordingly reduce the amount available by way of working partner salaries. In the Excel of the assessing officer tenable ILVA, the answer is no. Assessing officer is not correct because this is the case law decided recently by the Supreme Court that this income is the business income. Interest income is the business income because due to the amount deposited in the bank is related to the normal business expenditure. There this will be not other income, this is the business income. And part B, Sri Chandok is running a factory in Nagpur for first 10 years. He sold the factory building for rupees 80 lakhs and the considerations was appropriated as rupees 20 lakhs for the buildings and 50 lakh rupees 50 lakhs for the land underneath for the buildings. The factory building is the only asset of the block on which depreciation was claimed and whose WDB was 1 lakh rupees 1 lakh 30 thousand. The index cost of acquisition of the land amount rupees 22 lakhs. He deposited 48 lakh rupees in the capital gains of bonds of NHAI within 2 months after the sale of the factory building. The assessing officers disallowed the claim of the exceptions on the reasoning that capital gains and transfer of depreciable assets being short term is eligible for the exemption under section 54EC. Is the action of assessing officer valid in law? The question asked about the land is also is not depreciable asset while the factory building is a depreciable asset. We know that we bifurcate in the two parts, factory building like a land and the building, and building is depreciable, land is not non-depreciable. Therefore, if you are going to the claim and 54EC exemption is available from the long-term capital gains, and but it can be claimed from also land sale procedures. Part C, 4C Part C, Gobind Charitable Trust registered under section 12AA is engaged in the imparting yoga to the public. Its aggregate annual receipt was rupees 6 lakhs and is spent only rupees 40 lakhs by way of the remuneration to the yoga teachers and by way of administration expenses. The trust applied for approval under section 80G to the Commissioner of Income Tax. The application was rejected on the ground that it had not spend 85% of the income of the charitable purposes despite the validity of the arrival conditions. The issue is that why ATG if disallowed the applications, rejected the application, this is the ground that if expenditure 85% has not been expended. Answer number 4D. Said and Company, a dealer motor vehicles, conducted motor cycles races on the occasion of its 25th year anniversary. The prize was given to the first three winners by way of a luxury motorcycle which was worth rupees 2 lakhs rupees each. The assessee did not deduct tax sources on the prize when it is the owner. The assessing officers treated the assessee as and the assessee in default and passed order under section 201(1) and 201(1)(a). The assessee seeks your advice on the validity of the order and other legal consequences advice. And question number 4, part E. Dravid P. Limited is engaged in the manufacture of the electrical items. It received deposit from the distributors and supplied goods in the market through the distribution. It could not locate the some distributions with the whom where I was no transactions for the past 5 years or so. The income tax assessment was completed under section 243 subsection 3, but the issue of unclaimed deposits of the distribution was never discussed. The assessing officers issued a notice under section 148 after 4 years from the end of the relevant assessment year, but without qualifying the amount of income which had exceeded assessment. The assessee challenged the matter in appeal by contending that the assessing officers, without being denied of the quantum of income escaping assessment, could not have initiated reassessment proceeding decide the validity of the contention of the assessee. Now question number 5 asks, first part is the 8 marks. Ricky, a foreign nationals and the cricketers, came to India as a member of the South African cricket teams in the year India 31st March 2018. He received rupees 4 lakhs for the participation in the match in India. He also received rupees 1.5 lakhs for the advertisement, a product on radio. He wrote an article for a local newspapers and received 20,000 rupees for it. During he His stay in India, he also won a prix of ₹25,000 from the horse racing in Kolkata. He has no other income in India during the year. You are required to, first part, ask, compute his tax liability in India for assessment year 2018-19. Second part, compute whether these income